Sue the T-Rex may be one of the most famous dinosaur fossils ever discovered. The skeleton was named after the person who found it, American explorer Sue Hendrickson. But while the fossil shares her name, if you ask Sue or the person who runs the fossil's social media accounts, they'll point out that Sue is actually gender neutral. Their media persona is neither male or female, and Sue is referred to using they-them pronouns. That's because, well, we just don't know what sex Sue the actual Tyrannosaurus Rex was back when they were alive. Which raises the question, can we ever be sure of the sex of any fossil creatures? Well, there are clues to a fossil's sex, but they might not be what you think. How can you tell whether an ancient animal was male or female? After all, reproductive organs are usually soft tissue, and that doesn't preserve well. It's incredibly rare, but sometimes we do get lucky and find animals preserved with soft tissue, like with frozen mammoths. In those cases, you can just, well, look under the hood, so to speak. In some other cases, an animal's reproductive equipment does leave clear traces behind, even without their soft tissue. Some male mammals have a baculum, which is a bone that supports the penis. So if you see one of those, it's a pretty clear indication that the animal was male. At other times, we've been lucky enough to find fossils that have eggs inside of them, or which we think might be pregnant. In 2003, scientists announced that they had found a fossil of a marine reptile called an ichthyosaur that had two embryos inside its body. Based on their skeletal features, orientation, and lack of trauma, researchers think that they really were embryos, not food. And if there are babies inside a fossil animal, it's probably female. Unless it's like a seahorse or something. But what about eggs that have been laid? Dinosaurs and other egg layers have been found alongside eggs that were already laid, but male animals will also sometimes incubate or care for nests, so that doesn't end up telling us too much. Though, put a pin in this, because we'll come back to something cool about egg layers later. But maybe we don't need to always find babies or eggs to determine an animal's sex. Maybe just their bones are enough. And the reason for that is sexual dimorphism. In many species of animal, males and females look different. Think of how male peacocks are flashy and colorful, and females are more drab. Or how male silverback gorillas are much bigger than the females and have, well, silver backs. Sometimes these differences run so deep that they're visible in the skeleton. If you're looking at a whole bunch of animals of one species, and there's two really distinct size categories, you may be looking at sexual dimorphism. And many scientists have pored over fossil skeletons looking for any kind of evidence of sexual dimorphism. In dinosaurs, scientists have looked at things like tail and hip anatomy, which could be different between males and females due to the need to lay eggs. Others have looked at things like how big the animals were, or look for differences in the skull crests that could suggest they had a fancy look to entice the other sex. In 2021, scientists reported seeing sexual dimorphism in the size of giant ground sloth's canine teeth, which indicates that one sex would have bigger fangs than the other. Males of quite a few species of primates will have larger canine teeth than the females do, though our specific human lineage seems to have lost that trait a while back. We're also less dimorphic in body size, and researchers are still trying to figure out exactly how long ago that happened. Scientists have been debating whether species in the homonym genus Australopithecus were dimorphic, for instance, though recent evidence points towards some size dimorphism in those guys. And while males and females in the genus Homo have basically equally sized canines, we're still not sure if the males and females would have had roughly the same body mass, or had body size dimorphism more like, say, chimpanzees. Plus, modern humans have another odd distinction, which is body fat distribution. Human females have a higher percentage of body fat than males, and we have very little way of knowing how long ago that particular evolutionary quirk might have arisen. But whether it's our own ancestors or other animals, even if we do see differences in sizes or shapes of fossil skeletons, figuring out whether that's based on sex can be tricky. For one thing, individual variation can be huge even within a sex. There's always the possibility there'd be overlap in the size difference between the largest females and the smallest males, or vice versa for species where females are larger. And in many cases, we just don't know a lot of the nitty-gritty of what past species were really like. We're often working off of what we know about existing relatives or general biological rules of thumb. So it can be really hard hard to tease out which skeletal differences are due to sex and which are due to individual variation or from living in different areas or ecosystems. This is made even harder by the fact that for many species, there just aren't that many fossils to examine. T-Rex might be the most famous dinosaur ever, but we have fewer than 100 fossil specimens of the species. That means paleontologists need to work off a small number of individuals who may have been separated from each other by thousands of miles and hundreds of thousands of years. In 2017, a Canadian paleobiologist did statistical tests of fossils from 9 different dinosaur species, including T-Rex, Allosaurus, and Protoceratops, and his model found no evidence of sexual dimorphism. There was too much overlap in the sizes, and there weren't two clear groups within the species that we could argue were males and females. A 2021 analysis found that some dinos, including Allosaurus, did appear to be dimorphic, but the results weren't a slam dunk. In both cases, the analyses were held back by the limited number of fossils. That said, there have been some finds where we have managed to find enough fossils from one species to make a judgment. We found hundreds of fossils of an early Cretaceous bird called Confuciusornis. It looks like the males had two long pendant-like tail feathers, while the females didn't. And that lines up with what we see in a lot of modern-day dinosaurs, which you also know as birds. In 2017, scientists working with tiny fossil crustaceans were able to analyze over 6,000 individual fossils, and they did indeed find some dimorphism in the population. But there's one final trick up our sleeve for figuring out what sex certain fossils, including dinosaurs, were. Remember when I said to put a pin in the egg-laying question? It turns out one of the most promising pieces of evidence for figuring out the sex of a fossil dinosaur may be medullary bone. Medullary bone is a layer of calcium-rich tissue on the inside of birds' leg bones. It's found today in female birds as a way to store calcium needed during egg-laying. So we can look at the skeletons of any egg-laying fossil species to see if we find the medullary bone. And if we do, we can tell that individual was a female. In 2005, researchers found medullary bone in one T-Rex skeleton. And since then, it's also been reported in other dinosaurs, like theropods, as well as other critters like pterosaurs. And the good news is, we don't need to break open those leg bones to find it, since we can use techniques like CT scans to peek inside. Medullary bone only appears in mature, reproductive females, which means that any fossil that doesn't have it can't automatically be considered male. But it's still one of the most surefire ways we have to know definitively what sex an individual fossil was. That said, the sex of many fossils may continue to be a mystery. We may never know for sure if Sue the T-Rex was a male or a female, but that doesn't make their room at the Field Museum any less crowded with visitors eager to take a look. Thanks for watching this episode of SciShow. If you liked it, you may want to check out PBS Eons, another show made by our parent company, Complexly. PBS Eons tells the story of the past and how we learn about ancient life from the fossils that they leave behind. We really loved their recent episode on past mass extinctions, and we think you will too. So click the link below and check them out.